linked to the places where I've used it. So, for example, I don't know. The closest thing I've ever done to this is I spent 6 weeks in Jakarta with the Indonesians. So that was a long time ago. Most of my experience with countries has been on the international aspects of their system, of their tax system. This project is much broader than that. It covers really the whole tax system. But I've been around taxation for over 50 years, and I have worked in a lot of countries, and I know a lot of tax systems. I don't know the Colombian system very well, but I do think that I have certain views on how a tax system should function. And from my perspective, this is an opportunity to attempt to improve the Colombian system without getting involved in Colombian politics. It's all policy. So I have pretty strong views on how tax policy should work. And my working party is corporate tax, which is a good working party for me. I know much more about that than about the value-added tax. So you'll find that I have pretty strong views on how the system should apply. And it's not a direct application of what I've done in other countries, but it's years and years of working in taxation. Well, most tax policy people, and I consider myself a tax policy people, are very skeptical about incentives. Incentives tend to be wasteful. They tend to might be complicated. They tend to lead to corruption. There's a lot of aspects of incentives that I don't like, and that's in any country. Most countries have them. A lot of countries have them, particularly in South America. My experience with the incentives I've seen is usually that they haven't been very helpful at all. The best thing for a country, you'll hear me say this again and again, is to keep incentives to a minimum and use the money that's saved to lower the overall taxes. I mean, the best incentive you can have is to have a simple, low-rate tax system. That's your best bet. Now, politics keeps getting in the way. It keeps on interfering with that. And I have no, I'm not involved with that. I'm not going to say anything about politics. But from a policy standpoint, as far as I'm concerned, the people who want incentives have the burden of proof. It's up to them to demonstrate that the incentives really pay off, because by and large, incentives tend to be wasteful. So I'm a skeptic about incentives. Well, okay, you know, if you step back and ask yourself, what are the attributes of a good tax system? There's, as far as I'm concerned, there's really three. One of them is what the economists call efficiency, and that means interfering as little as possible with economic behavior. So what you want to do is you want a tax system that raises money, because that's what the tax system is there for, but it basically allows the economics to play out with as little interference as possible. That's one attribute. A second attribute is fairness. You want a tax system that's fair. And just as important as being fair is a tax system that's perceived to be fair. In other words, it's more, whether the tax system is ultimately fair or not doesn't matter if it's not perceived to be fair, because you can't have a tax agency that serves as a policeman. You really want a tax system that functions on its own, and for that to happen, it has to be accepted by taxpayers. And that the basic attitude, the basic way of getting a tax system accepted is fairness. And the third attribute of a good tax system is simplicity. You want a tax system that can be administered by tax administrators and understood by them. It can be understood and complied with by taxpayers. And there's as little room as possible for arguing about how the system applies and therefore for corruption to intervene into the system. So I would say the three basic things you're shooting for are efficiency, fairness, and simplicity. Now there's a problem because those three attributes are sometimes interfere with one another. Sometimes the most efficient system is not the simplest system. But I think of the three attributes, the one that I would favor, particularly in a country like Colombia, is simplicity. I would aim as much as possible for simplicity. And that argues against a lot of incentives. Well, I think it helps if the taxpayer realizes that other people in the same situation are also paying taxes. I mean, nobody likes to pay taxes, but if the system is adopted fairly and is applied fairly across the board, that goes a long way. I mean, it undermines the system if taxpayers look at their neighbors and say that person or that corporation is getting a better deal than I am. That's a bad, you don't want that because that interferes with compliance. Then people tend to cheat on their taxes. What you really want is you want a system, everybody, if you're gonna have a government, you're gonna have to have taxes. Let's start there. I mean, if you're gonna have a country and you're gonna have a government, you're gonna have to pay for it. And that means people have to accept that. And I think the best tax system goes back to that basic idea. It's part of the social compact. If you're going to live if they're going to be policemen and firemen and the streets are going to be paved, you know, you need people to accept the system. And I think the simpler the system, the fairer the system, the easier it is to get it accepted. Yeah, I see the pandemic as an opportunity. In other words, it's a once in a lifetime event that affects everybody. And it's a chance, which you would probably otherwise wouldn't get, to go back to first principles and think, what are we doing here? I mean, I would start at the very first principles, you know, back to when taxes started. Taxes are fundamental to government. I mean, they're fundamental to everything. Without taxes, you don't have the money to do anything. So you need to raise taxes and you need to educate people to the need to raise taxes. My sense is Colombia has got a pretty strong sense of nationality. I mean, the people, I've been in Bogota several times. I have a lot of friends, a lot of ex-students from including Jose Romero. I have a lot of ex-students who are from Colombia. And there's a sense of nationhood. You're not like Argentina where the country is always sort of falling apart. Colombia's got a real sense of being a country. And I think the right thing to do is to appeal to people, to appeal to the population. Now you're going to have problems, no question. You're never going to get everybody, but you want to hear from a bunch of people. I will be surprised if people will argue with the principles that I would favor. The question is the political will to carry them forward. And I think with the government, I see the pandemic as an opportunity. I mean, it is a terrible time. I don't think there's any particular tax measure that I would advocate as a result of the pandemic. But the pandemic offers, I think, the world, individual countries, an opportunity to stop and take a second look at what they're doing, including, especially in the area of taxation. So that's why I see the pandemic. Well, I mean, I would start with a blank page, you know, start all over again and rebuild the system. That's very ambitious. I don't know what's possible in the Colombian context, but I would rebuild the system. And you know, in that rebuilding, I wouldn't exclude incentives, but I would say that the burden is on the people who want incentives to explain why they're beneficial and how they pay for themselves. And you know, for every incentive you give, what you're basically doing is you're raising the tax on somebody else. And you know, politicians tend to think they're just giving money away from incentives, but you need to pay for government. So if you give the money away to Mr. X, you're taking it from Mr. Y. And I think it's important for government people, when they meet with taxpayers who have a particular point of view, to remember that there are other taxpayers who aren't in the room, and those other taxpayers have an interest in a fair system. So you know, I just think it's a chance to rethink everything. I think what Columbia is doing here is very sensible. Well, I'm hopeful that I know it'll be interesting. I hope that we can make a contribution. I mean, you know, I don't have any illusions. I've advised lots of countries and lots of times, and there's always complications. But you know, it seems to me that where I come, I have nothing to gain from this. Zero. I have no personal interest in, you know, any. I don't own property in Colombia. I don't pay tax in Colombia. I'm completely an outsider, and I will just give the best advice I can, and it'll be interesting to see what reaction it is. I will say I'm happy to work with the other members of this commission, and particularly, although I know Jeffrey and I know Pascal, the person I really know best is Brian Arnold. I do have one suggestion for the commission, which I think is going to be followed, which is not to silo the experts in individual. I mean, we can be in charge of individual working parties, but there ought to be some degree of cross-fertilization because Brian is very, very knowledgeable, probably more knowledgeable than I am on advising countries on developing their tax system. So I would want to see him very much involved. And I think we're pretty much on the same page.